way of thinking about economy for Taiwanese people. Okay, but why, you know, we think this way? Because, you know, we feel that actually the Taiwanese politics and the Taiwan society has been, you know, controlled gradually by the business group, the big business group. That's one of the problems. We have the democracy, but actually the money, you know, is louder than the people's vote, and the people's vote can be affected by the money, because the way, you know, the election is running in Taiwan. So actually, just like I said, that, you know, if the people, the yellow line represent the people's salary, the regular earning, you can see from the 2000 to, you know, actually to right now, there's no change. There's a salary stagnation actually there. But, you know, if you say that, you know, Taiwanese economy is not growing, but actually the blue line represent the economic growth. So, you know, actually in terms of the GDP, actually Taiwan, you know, has been growing gradually. But if you look at the salary, especially the young people's salary, actually, you know, in the 15 years, it never, you know, get a raise. So that's the problem. And don't even talk about the price of the real estate has been, you know, like triple, compared to the 15 years ago. So, you know, why, you know, actually the Taiwanese economy has not been that bad, but, you know, all the employees didn't get any benefit. And we have the same question to the so-called the cross trade, the trading in the service, you know, industry, not only the service industry. So who gained the profit from that? Actually, not the employee, actually the only the business group, you know, they gain the main profit, you know, so that's our issue about that. So we think that, you know, the social democracy, you know, maybe it can solve the problem in some way, because, you know, it represents the freedom, equality, and solidarity, you know. So our main argument is that, you know, we need to have a new Taiwanese progressive even. Of course, it's about Taiwan, because we don't need to talk about the sovereignty issue anymore. It's already been solved, you know, at least for most of the Taiwanese people. You know, very few people at that time want to have a unification with mainland China, less than 10%. So, you know, all the Penghu and Penghui, you know, the conflict, you know, should be upgraded, you know. So we should start to discuss, you know, whether we need to give up the old economic development model that sacrificed labor justice and environment. So that's our main argument. Okay, so we start to, you know, organize the party, and we have some, you know, the common platforms about like pension. The first one is about raising the salary. The second one is about the pension reform. The third one is about the taxation fairness. The fourth one is about the transparency in politics. And the fifth one is about the diversity of the whole society, including the marriage equality, the gay issue, or and the gender equality, and also the fairness to the Aboriginal people. Okay, things like that. Okay, this is just to show you our candidate, including myself, you know. Okay, actually, we have six candidates, I mean, running, you know, as the district legislator. They are all, you know, looks. I'm the oldest there, you know. So the reason that I become a candidate is because, you know, we figure out that we want to organize a new political party. I mean, the main organizers are NGO people, including professors. But no one wants to run for the election, so it's not going to work, right? So we have to start to look for the candidates first. And then, you know, when I try to persuade other people to be a candidate, they will ask, you know, why yourself, you know, you don't want to be a candidate. So I have to be a candidate first, and then I can find other candidates. That's the reason that I become a candidate myself. And Da'an district is where the Taida is located. Actually, it's the most, the deepest, you know, district in the Taiwan. We call it just like the Jingmen Mazu, because it always support the KMT. So for us, you know, our temporary political goal for that election is first to Taotai KMT, you know, and later on to monitor DPP. Taotai KMT means that, you know, we want the KMT to disappear, you know. So we all chose the very painful, you know, electoral district to run the election. Okay, yeah. Okay. so this is our volunteer. You can see that most of our volunteers, they are very young, you know. So actually, yeah, you know, they are the young people. So we have the passion and, you know, the young people to be our volunteer. The only thing we lack just the money. Okay. Yeah, this is to show our, you know, the new place don't work. Actually, we learned something from the Green Party in Australia because we have some volunteers that came from, you know, they have been some, they have some experience in working for the Green Party in Australia. So we try to use the question mayor, you know, to get people to discuss about the so-called the 政见, or policy issue. Because in the past, you know, the Taiwanese voters still didn't have the chance to discuss the policy issues. They always discuss about the candidate's image or the party's image. Okay, so we try to have our, you know, some new political work to, you know, yeah, to try to run the new election. Okay. So this is just a picture. You can see that, you know, we were really campaigning hard, you know. So I took one semester off from Taida to be a full-time candidate. Okay. So what's the result of our election? You know, we didn't get a seat, you know, as you might already know. But actually, you know, it's a good start for this new party, you know. So we got the 2.5, you know, percent of all the votes, you know. So we already beat the Taiwan Tailin, the Taiwan Solidarity Union, and also the Mingguo Dang is a kind of a very rich party, you know, with lots of resources and some, you know, yeah, politician. Okay. So our candidate, for me, I got the 56K votes, you know, in Dan district. Actually, it's the historical, the best result for the opposition party. Okay. And all other candidates, you know, actually they were faced a challenging from the KMT and both the DPP, but you know they all got some like more than 10% of the votes, you know, in that single district. Okay. So actually, for our young candidate, for example, Miao Huoya, he's only 27. Okay. He just graduated from the Law Department of National Taiwan University, and he has been working hard for some judicial reform association for quite a few years. Okay. Yeah. So every candidate got enough support to compete for the seat of city council, and some of them already decided to run for the next election, the city councilor. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So my last words. Okay. Yeah. I think, you know, for us, you know, never give up. Building a better society is very important. Yeah, so we want to envision a new Taiwan with equality and diversity. So that's the colorful, you know, yeah, the map of Taiwan. So, okay, so just march forward. So hope you can join our, you know, march. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, I now invite our panelists to assume the stage. So now we're going to have